theologian and an Oxford don, he said, though we pray not on them, as some other cannibals do, on other people that is, though we pray not on them, yet by a subtle cookery of nature, we eat them at second hand. So we all become cannibals. From the bodies of the dead springs up grass. This, when eaten by the ox, is turned into flesh. This we eat, and the flesh of the ox becomes ours. So you don't have to just be eaten by a cannibal for there to be problems. When you're buried, bits of you get integrated into grass, get eaten by cows and or ox, and then if you eat ox, or some human beings will do, those bits get reingested into somebody else. So what happens on the day of resurrection? What is going to be lifted up out of the ground? It's not clear at all. So it's a really serious problem. And this was the background that Locke was working with. This is, I believe, a very significant aspect of Locke's theory about the nature of persons, is his attempt to solve this puzzle. So there are different ways of solving it. Robert Boyle, Locke's contemporary, chose an easy way out, the God can do anything solution. You can worry about it. It would be a problem, except that God is all powerful, so God can just do anything. So God will have to find a way of zapping all the bits from all these different places into the appropriate body, and then you can be resurrected whole. That's an easy way out. And I don't know how plausible it was in the 17th century, but it's not that plausible to me now. That's what's going to happen. I wonder how many people you will find who really believe that on the day of resurrection, they may believe in a day of resurrection, but are we really going to be made whole from all these different bits? And then as you went into the grave, was that before they embalmed you? Is it after they embalmed you?